G'day, welcome back to Colecandoo. In this episode, we're going to look at items that appear in square brackets. You'll see these in some panels, such as all of the styles panels, the swatches panel, and the preflight panel, just to name a few. So, what about them? These items are special because they are the default values that ship with InDesign and cannot be renamed or deleted, and in some instances, cannot be edited. Let's start by having a look at the swatches panel. By default, the InDesign swatches panel looks like this. There are four colours that are in square brackets: none, registration, paper, and black. Notice all but one of these colours can't be edited, as indicated by the strike-through pen icon. Interestingly, we can edit the paper colour. So I'll create a new document to demonstrate this. Anyway, with nothing selected, let's change a paper color by right-clicking it on the swatches panel. Bonus tip: right-click on a style or color to edit it instead of double-clicking with the left button to avoid inadvertently applying what I'm changing to something that might be selected on the page. The panel appears, and note that I can't change its name or color type, but can choose a color mode of lab, CMYK, or RGB, but nothing else. Let's change it to 100% cyan just for fun. What happened here? The page has gone blue. Will it look that way if I export to a PDF? Well, no. Instead, the page is white. So what's happening here? The paper colour is not pretending to be white, but rather mimicking the colour of the substrate that the artwork is being applied to. This could be used to show what artwork would look like if printed on newsprint. So let's change that colour to a newspaper-like colour. However, I'll undo this, as there is a better way of simulating that colour, and that is to go to the View menu, select Proof Setup, and click Custom. And in the new dialog box, select Simulate Paper Colour, and choose the profile I want. However, colour proofing and matching is a video series all on its own, so let's focus back on the brackets. In this new document, let's look at this colour called Registration. It's a unique colour that appears on every colour separation, whether it's cyan, magenta, yellow, black, or a spot colour. It's meant for prepress marks such as crop marks, registration marks, or slur marks. It should not be used as a colour for applying to general artwork, as it will go beyond the ink density for paper. Ink density is a limit where the amount of ink in a particular location can't be absorbed by the paper and will wrinkle, or will cause drying issues with the paper. Ink densities vary depending on the stock that's being used. In this example, I don't want the density to be higher than 300%. In my separations preview, from the drop-down, I can select Ink Limit. And notice that the majority of the pages become red, telling me that my ink limit is beyond 300%. So I need to change this color to something else. In this situation, I would prepare a color called Rich Black. I'll start with an open square bracket and type in rich black and end with a square bracket. I receive an error message saying it's an invalid swatch name, please choose another. This is the other feature about square bracket items. They generally belong to default items, and you generally cannot name a new swatch style or item with square brackets, with three exceptions. stroke styles, a flattener preset, or a trap preset. Back to my rich black. I'll just call it rich black, and I'll give it the values that I like to use in a rich black. If you disagree with these values, please post in the comments the values you believe the rich black should be. And now my ink limit is all good. Okay, so that worked. But I don't really want to select registration by mistake, because it looks exactly like black. I can't rename it, don't touch. I also can't delete it. Can I put it in a folder called don't touch? No. However, I can move it to the top of the list. So now I know to avoid using this color. But that will only make that setting for this document. To do this for any future documents, I have to close all the documents that I have open. And then make my change. So just to prove that these swatches can't be deleted, let's go select all unused. And it selects all of the swatches except for the square bracket ones. But for some reason, it's left cyan. Any reason it doesn't select cyan? I'll give you some thinking music. Worked it out? It's because cyan is used in the basic paragraph style. If I go to my paragraphs and shading, you'll see it's used as the default shading. If I change that color to black, I should be able to select all unused, and it will select cyan as well, right? No, it doesn't. It's not that simple. Cyan still isn't selected from the select unused colors option. Instead, we have to get rid of cyan and replace it with black. I can then add cyan back in. It's not a hard color to add. Let's move it up to where it was because I'm picky. And now, if I go select all unused, it selects everything except for the square bracketed items. While some default bracketed items can be altered, I'd also exercise caution in changing them if sharing the files with others, given that these items are in every InDesign file. But when an item is copied from one file to another and has the same style name, the copied item adopts the formatting of the document it's being copied into. If I look at the basic graphics frame in the left-hand document, you'll see it has a fill of magenta applied to it. It has a rounded corner applied to it. And has this gaudy drop shadow applied to it. So when I copy that and paste it into my new document, it's now a white square because the basic graphics frame in the right-hand document had no fill applied, had no round corners, and has no drop shadow. Now, this behavior is true of any style, default or otherwise, but it's a good reason to generally leave most of the defaults alone. Lastly, I often hear the advice given generally about exporting high-quality PDFs if working with a commercial printer. However, this setting doesn't preserve bleeds or crops and has to be added separately, so let me demonstrate. When I navigate to the marks and bleeds, I have to add the crops add my page information, and use my document bleeds, which were 3 millimeters, which you can see down here. But note, once I've done that, it adds a word modified to the end. So while I can export this PDF and it will appear correctly, if this is something a user needs to do all the time and they follow the same instructions, they navigate to high quality print, they have to set this every time. So my opinion would be to make a new setting. That's it for another video. If you got something out of this video, show me by hitting the like button and subscribe for more great videos. Check out Colecandoo or InDesign Secrets for the latest articles, or tweet me at Colecandoo. Until next time, I'll see you later.